DAX offers you two functions to take a selection of dates and shift it back and forth over time. They are DATEADD and SAMEPERIODLASTYEAR. SAMEPERIODLASTYEAR is a simple function whose only goal is to shift the time back 1 year. DATEADD is a more generic function that where you can specify both the amount of the shifting and its unit of measure. Let's see them with an example. In this first example, I have a selection of dates that starts from the 15th of July 2008 up to the 31st of July 2008. And I use same period last year to retrieve the same period 1 day, 1 year back. So the calculate table applies a filter between start date and end date, and same period last year returns a table with the same selection 1 year back. You see that the result goes from the 15th of July 2007, so 1 year back compared with 2008, and goes back to the 31st of July 2007. SAMEPERIODLASTYEAR is very frequently used, but it has the limitation that can only shift time back 1 year. If you need more flexibility, then you need to use DATEADD. Using DATEADD, you use DATEADD and specify both the amount of the shifting and also the unit of measure. Using DATEADD minus 1 year results in the same period last year. So if I have a selection of dates from the 1st of January 2008 up to the 31st of January and I use minus 1 year, I run the query and I obtain all the dates between the 1st of January 2007 up to the 31st of January 2007. The main advantage of using DATEADD is that you can change the selection and go back, for example, 1 quarter. Starting from the 1st of January 2008 and going back 1 quarter, I obtain the 1st of October 2007, that is the same period, shift back 1 quarter. DATEADD has quite a complex logic that let it detect when the current selection includes a full period. Look at this example. I have a selection where I start from the 1st of February 2008 up to the 29th of February 2008. So the selection contains 29 days, but that selection happens to be an entire month. And if I use DATEADD to shift this period ahead 1 month, the new selection will contain from the 1st of March 2008 up to the 31st of March 2008. DATEADD detected that the selection contained the full month of February, and instead of returning 29 days of March, returned the full period. So it has a selection which is larger than the original one. The same happens the other way around. If I select from the 1st of March to the 31st of March and I go back 1 month, now I start from a selection with 31 days, but going back 1 month, because February does not have 31 days, it will produce a result containing only 29 days, so the entire month of March. The logic is quite complex, and we have written it in the DAX Guide website. It's not worth going into all the details. What really matters is that it usually works fine. So when you have a selection of a period, either a month or a quarter, you obtain the same period in a previous time frame, but containing the same overall logic. An important detail about all these functions is that they are table functions. Their result is a table, like any other time intelligence function. The reason is that you will typically use this function as an argument of calculate. So you write calculate, sales amount, or whatever measure, and you use same period last year to shift time back of the period. Then I use this expression inside an outer calculate that applies the filter context. You typically do not have the outer calculate because that is the filter created by Power BI or whatever client tool to force your calculation to work in a specific period. The result of same period last year is a table containing all the dates from the 1st of January 2007 up to the 31st of January 2007, and this is a table that Calculate uses to modify the filter context and perform the calculation under a different filter context. The result are the sales in the period that has been shifted by same period last year. Another important detail is about the syntax of these functions. You write same period last year, date, But actually, the arguments of same period last year, is the argument is not a reference to a column, but it's a table. DATEADD is nothing but syntax sugar for the more complex expression that is same period last year, calculate table, distinct DATEADD. So distinct retrieves a table, calculate table performs context transition. This is an important detail because when you use DATEADD or same period last year, context transition is happening. Therefore, running these functions in a row context might trigger context transition, and you need to be aware of that in order to understand the results which are coming out. As a last detail, let's see these functions in action. I have a query that retrieves the calendar year month, the sales amount in the calendar year month, and then I use calculate to go back 1 month, 1 quarter, or 1 year with same period last year. Let's look at the result. January 2007 has 794 as the value. In February, sales amount shows the value of February, but same period last month, going back 1 month, returns still the value of January. The value of the last quarter is blank at the beginning because there is nothing in the previous quarter, but when you are in April, you see that in April it shows 794, which is the same 1 month, but in the previous quarter. Similarly, for the year, it is blank at the beginning and it starts to show 794, that is the value of January 2007, when we are in January 2008. You can use this function to shift time back and forth and to compute many time intelligence calculations.